VVT variable valve timing is used on many engines, the Corsa D 1.4 included. This video covers the camshaft adjuster gear, also known as the phaser, how to strip, clean, inspect and reassemble it, how it works and some of the fault symptoms. The actuator solenoid controlled by a pulse signal from the ECU operates the oil control valve, opening a shuttle valve directing oil to the camshaft adjuster to either side of its chambers to advance or retard the camshaft by turning it within the camshaft adjuster gear. Stripping down the camshaft adjuster gear is quite easy. It's my experience that it's well worth inspecting these if you have the engine stripped down for any reason, like when renewing a timing chain. The main return spring is very powerful, so take care when removing it. The spring cover states don't open because of this. The spring is tricky to refit. I cover replacing it later in the video. Remove the base and top covers, then the lock spring and plunger. Check for visible damage and excessive wear to the surfaces and vanes. Check for free movement between the outer gear casing and the inner vane housing that marries with the camshaft. Next, check that all the oil channels between the outer gear casing and the inner vane housing are not blocked. Check that the plunger that locks the outer gear casing with the inner vane housing is serviceable and locks in place easily. This plunger is lifted up by oil pressure, unlocking the two housings to ensure camshaft advance and retard movement when the engine is running. When reassembling, be sure to align the timing marks as shown. Refitting the mainspring is tricky. I used a thin cable tie as shown. Note where the spring fits about the protruding pins. It's a little difficult to lever them into place. Obviously, caution is required as you tension the spring to make sure it doesn't jump off or up at you. I found it easier once I had fitted the spring to secure the phaser in the vise with a spacer, then cut the cable tie to pull it free. Symptoms are logical. Low oil pressure or thick oil will obviously affect if and how the camshafts will rotate. If the solenoid actuator, oil control valve or camshaft adjuster gear are defective, camshafts that are in the wrong position will affect valve timing, leading to the likes of rough idling, low power and engine noise.